I think you just get used to hearing no. It comes in different shapes, different forms. When I was growing up in Ghana, I remember meeting up with one very renowned surgeon in Ghana, and I told him I wanted to become a surgeon, and he just laughed. He's like, no, he's like, it's more appropriate that you become a nurse. But that was just another no. Why can't I do it? Of course I can do it. If anyone else can, then why can't I, just because I'm a female? And that notion really I struggled with. So I was on that journey to prove the fact that as a female, I could become a doctor and I could become a surgeon. As a black female in America, in medicine, what can I do? What can I not do? I was born in the capital of Ghana, which is called Accra. For several years, I slept on a rag on the floor in the same bedroom as my family. There were six of us in this room. The mat on the floor was basically the bed for me and my brother that we shared. It was tough growing up. Things improved over time, but there weren't a lot of opportunities. You know, we had a guidance counselor who said, you are an international student. Very few programs are going to take you. So you should spend a year getting an MPH or doing something else. I decided to go study abroad. It just felt like I would constantly be fighting against a system that was not supportive of me succeeding. When I decided to come to the US, I had to study for the SATs. In order to get access to material, I took a job at the US Embassy. And then it came up to time to register for schools. You needed to have an email address. What came to mind was Violet. Violet was my mom's nickname. Her friends had given her that nickname because they had read about the violet flower, and they said she was so unique. This represents this movement, this mission I'm on, to become Violet. And then Surg was, I had decided I was going to be the first female Ghanaian cardiothoracic surgeon. And it came up again when it was applying into surgery. My personality was very different compared to who was going into surgery then. Why surgery? More appropriate for pediatrics or OB-GYN. In Ghana, there's a whole belief in that the more you say something, you can speak it into being. So I combined Violet, which was this mission, with Surg, which was this dream, and it became Violet Surg. The part that I really loved was the operating room. It was so amazing. I felt alive, I felt awake, I was energized. There was something magical that happens when I'm in the OR. Time flew. There's a lot of different moving parts, but at the same time, folks know that they are working towards this common aim of taking care of the patient. So when I'm in a case for 12 hours, it is all about them. It is knowing who they are. The fact that what I am doing in this moment allows them to get better and get back to living with their families and then living their lives, dreaming big, attaining their own dreams. And that is special. That is precious. No matter where you are heading, there are times when the road just seems a little bit tougher. And I can't tell you the number of times when I myself have even said no to myself. And so I still face that. I think now I'm just a little bit more confident.